How did Palmerston come about? What did you want to create with that?
Well, I think I felt kind of isolated, having gone from Scaramouche into this kind of small catering company. Mm-hmm. I felt that I was able to really produce beautiful food in a very controlled environment because it was catering. I always knew how many people I was dealing with, how much food I needed to buy. There was plenty of time to plan and execute, mm-hmm. right? But I missed the restaurant. Right. I missed that community of people mm-hmm. all moving towards service together.
And you've owned a lot of different restaurants in the city, and you've worked in a lot of different restaurants. Some of them are places that I wouldn't have expected you to be in, like the Founders Club at the Rogers Center, the Arena. But the one restaurant that really is mostly identified with you was the Jamie Kennedy Wine Bar. You had a great run there, and it was a really popular destination. Unfortunately, the restaurant ended up having some financial issues. Can you speak to that a little bit?
Because of the success, maybe, the critical success of the wine bar, I felt that I could do anything, you know, and you start to believe in your own hype a little bit. And that's a very dangerous thing. And so it caused us at that time to expand beyond our capacity. That's what happened. I made a decision to build a commissary kitchen, mm-hmm. which became Gilead. It is Gilead. And because we were starting a catering business in addition to the wine bar, we were going back into the Gardner Museum as an exclusive caterer.
Right.
And it was in a very exciting new building mm-hmm. that was getting all kinds of accolades for its architectural design. And we were being billed as the exclusive caterer there, so it was a lovely match, and this gave us the confidence to invest in Gilead. However, what we didn't plan for was the additional cost to the company to run a commissary kitchen, let alone pay for the expansion or the mm-hmm. build out of that space. And we didn't build enough capacity into that space once it was going. Just plainly said, we didn't create enough business for ourselves. And because we were so exposed with the amount of staff that we mm-hmm. had hired and additional costs every way conceivable, very quickly we got into trouble. And we, in addition to that, our ability to broker the interest that we had in a catered events at the Gardner,
right.
We were not good. We did not staff our front office enough to take the interest in the calls. We were missing meetings. We just started to not do well.
There was too much going on and you couldn't balance it.
We right. started not to do well, and so we got a reputation very quickly as, you know, I wanted to go there, but
right.
it wasn't. We didn't get the response that we needed to organize it. So it hurt us. It hurt us badly. And enough so that in the end, I had to sell the wine bar, which was the jewel in the crown
yeah.
of the company,
mm-hmm.
in order to address debt.
Right.
And it was a tough, very, very, very tough time of my career. But I got to say that you know, I insisted that we not declare bankruptcy. That was definitely a route that we could mm-hmm. have gone.
Yep.
I felt an allegiance to all of the suppliers around me that I certainly owed money to, but that I wasn't going to let them down. And that just became our MO for the next 10 years. And quite honestly, still today, there still remains some of that difficult mm-hmm. Financial legacy. But I've learned so much,
I'm
Rosanna,
sure you have, yeah.
about business. I think I was naively successful for the first 30 years of my career for one reason or another. I did very well, but it was always about, you know, having these ideas and the ideas being good and people wanted to support them, but we just kind of made it through the mm-hmm. business part without really paying attention all that much. And so when this happened, it was all of a sudden, okay, now I have to really start paying attention as the owner and
right.
operator of this company. And as I said, so now I think I'm a much better business person as a result.